Hello everyone, today we will discuss the part 45 of the important notes for biochemistry so that you can easily able to answer the one-liners and the MCQs in your exam. The substrate for the elongation step in the transcription is the ribonucleotide triphosphates. Two high-energy phosphates are used to add one ribonucleotide. Termination of the transcription may be rho-dependent or rho-independent. Rho-dependent termination requires the rho protein and uses the ATP and helicase activity, and it also releases the RNA at the termination site. The inhibitor of the transcription are actinomycin D, rifamycin and the alpha-amanitin. The enhancer of the transcription increases the rate of initiation and can be located upstream or downstream of the promoter. Now, three post-transcriptional modifications occur in all the eukaryotic mRNA, and these are also known as the RNA processing. Okay, now these are, remember, capping at the 5' end. Okay, capping at the 5' end. Okay, then the removal of the introns, or we can say splicing. Okay, and the tailing, or we can say polyadenylate tail at the 3' end. So, three events occur over here. That means 5' capping, 3' polyadenylate tail addition over here at the 3' position, okay, and the splicing, that means removal of the introns from the particular sequence, is done in the post-transcriptional modification. Now over here, the 7-methyl guanosine cap is basically added at the 5' end of the mRNA by guanyl transferase by unusual 5'-5' triphosphate linkage. The methyl group over here is donated by the SAM, or the S-adenosyl methionine, by enzyme guanine 7-methyl transferase, and this basically occurs in the cytoplasm. Alternate splicing and the RNA editing are exceptions to one gene, one protein theory. CAP facilitates the initiation of the translation and stabilizes the mRNA by preventing it from attack by the 5' exonuclease, and by the capping and the addition of the polyadenylate tail and by the splicing, the particular mRNA is considered as the mature mRNA. At 3' end, a polyadenylate tail is added by enzyme polyadenylate polymerase. Now, splicing ribozymes are the self-splicing introns and the spliceosomal introns. Immature mRNA has both introns and the exons. Mature mRNA contains only exons. We discussed about this before also, right? Lariat formation occurs in the group 2 self-splicing introns and spliceosomal introns. Small nuclear RNA which takes part in the splicing are the U1, 2, 4, 5 and 6. Small nuclear RNA have unique 5' caps. SM class snRNA have 5' trimethyl guanosine caps, and the LSM class snRNA have 5' monomethyl phosphate caps. Differential RNA processing, or the RNA editing, is a mechanism to produce diverse set of the proteins from a limited set of genes. Transcription and the post-transcriptional modification occur in the nucleus, but in case of rRNA, they occur in the nucleolus. Regulatory sequences are present in the non-coding region of the DNA and interact with the regulatory molecules or the transcription factors to activate or repress the genes. The regulatory sequences are the cis acting if they control the gene expression of a gene that lies on the same chromosome as the regulatory sequence. So, regulatory sequence is are basically cis acting if they control the gene expression that lies on the same chromosome as the regulatory sequence. And the regulatory sequence are trans acting if they are produced from a particular gene from a chromosome, but they affect the regulation of a gene which is lying on the other chromosome. So, there's the difference between them. Protein motif is that modified portion of a regulatory protein which binds to response element on the DNA. Now, response element is a DNA sequence which gives a site of the protein binding. At this site of the DNA, protein motif bind. Now we have first of all the helix turn helix protein motif. Now these, as you can see over here, this is the helix turn helix protein motif. Now this basically regulate the genes of the development. Next is the zinc finger protein motif. Now the example of this is the steroid hormone receptors. Now next is the helix loop helix. Remember, this is the helix loop helix protein motif, and they basically regulate the immune system genes. And next is the leucine zipper. Now this leucine zipper basically regulate the cell division. So today up till here, we'll discuss about the further important notes in our next video. Thank you so much.